Oh shit, it's you guys again. Hey, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the channel. Y'all looking at my aft? Yeah, this is the 120 Atlas Vans build I've been working on for quite some time. It's a build series. We got the skins on top. Alright, I've actually put a coat of veil and epoxy the veil onto the boat. I've got this veil pretty much sanded off. I put the veil on to fill in any holes, you know, dips and do's, lilies, bilies, you know, and it's actually turned out pretty good. So, I got some epoxy mixed up. We're going to be using this in the video. We're going to get right to it. I've got some little low spots I want to fill in with epoxy on this. I've actually got to epoxy these non-trips and epoxy right down this guy here, last coat. And we're going to get the wing started and work on the cowling, okay? I've got the cowling, the hatch glued up, all right? My final piece on here, and I've been kind of profiling it. It's like a 7-8 piece hatch, all right? This is the hatch. I've been working on this the whole time I've been messing with the boat, trying to get it profiled perfect, all right? And the wing. It's a 3-piece wing, okay? We've got to epoxy this together, glue it together, and epoxy the base together. Same deal. It's a balsa, birch, balsa. We've got these carbon fiber tubes that we're going to run in it. I really wasn't going to use the wing, but I figured I would put it on there, just, you know, whatever. So we're gonna work on the wing, the hatch, and the bow. There's a bunch of different stuff I need to do. It's all really gonna be epoxy and sanding, and try to make it short for you guys, so stick around. So yeah, I almost forgot to start filming this part. I'm so excited to get the boat going. I almost forgot to film. like I said, we got birch in the middle, and these carbon fiber tubes go in the birch. Okay, same deal with the wing. We're gonna put these carbon fiber tubes in the wing right here, and they're gonna actually run through the base. All right, and that's going to pretty much hold it together, make it strong, okay? I guess we need to start by cutting the carbon fiber tube because I need to epoxy that in there. I've already got my epoxy mixed up, and I guess I need to hurry up. So I'm just going to kind of put this the side on there, and we're going to mark it. I'm gonna try to cut it with these snips. Let's see if that works. Oh yeah, it works. Good deal. All right, so that's a little too long. Perfect. All right, we'll sand the extra down. Need it. Oh man, I just broke that piece of balsa. Jeez. Well, that's gonna be glued together. Cut it a little bit long because we are human. Yeah, man, I'm ready to get this thing going. Let's copy that on this one. Alright, put that in there. I'm just kind of sanding down the edges real quick, you know, and save me some time after it's all put together. All right, so I'm just gonna go and do that to all four of them, and then we're gonna do the same thing to the base. I'll fast forward it to save a little bit of time. Yeah, V2, baby. So this was a V1 that I mocked up with some thick cardboard. All right, this is V2, okay? V2 of my little saucy shingle. All right. I'm actually using some thin cardboard, the same thickness as balsa. So when I draw up my templates, everything's going to be on the money, okay? See, I got all the templates drawn up. Boom, huh? And we're gonna make an outboard motor for it. Yeah. So let's start spreading some epoxy. I'm just gonna epoxy all these together. Try not to make a huge mess with this epoxy so that the winglets don't stick to every freaking thing when I put some weight on it. So I've got them all epoxied, okay? I've got these paper on top of them and on the bottom in case it's got epoxy on it, it won't stick to the weight or the table, and we can just sand that paper right off. You know what I'm saying? So make sure it's all squared up, and it looks like it is. Now I need to find something to put on this guy. You know what? I'm going to go get my anvil. I'm gonna use the pistons. I'm going to actually use a railroad tie. Boom. All right, so I'm just gonna go super light with epoxy on the bottom side of the boat. Okay, you guys have seen me do that 100 times. Tomorrow, when everything's good and dry, we'll start working on the cowling, which will be a few seconds for you guys. All right, it's the next day. Nice. I already peeled it off earlier. Looks good. Everything's nice and tight. Looks good. All right, so we're going to take this out to the shop. We're going to take the cowling and the boat out and give it a sand. All right. Oh, I didn't even think about the wing width. Okay, I basically thought it was ready to roll. I didn't even think about the width of the wing. Check this out. It's too freaking wide. It would have to go on like this, and I don't like that. So I'm gonna shorten up one side, redrill my carbon fiber. I got some more tubes, thank God. Pins. I'm gonna cut it down so it's like that. And while I'm doing it, you know what? I don't like it how high it is. I want it to be lower. I want it to be about right here. You know, I want it to be lower profile. All right, so. Probably not going to help out with any aerodynamics anyway. So I may reprofile the top, like I said, and I definitely want to cut it down. Oh, I didn't even think about that. That sucks. Oh man, big dummy. So right now I'm going to start profiling this. I'm just going to sand this down to fit. All right, it's all cured out. It needs to fit flush all the way around, sit flat on this deck. All right, so let's get to it. Let's get to it. So that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. All right, so that's pretty much done. I'll profile it. We still got to add the exhaust stacks right here, a little scoop that we got to put there, and I think there's a little scoop that goes up here, and we'll cut down this area here for the driver. I'll probably drill a couple of big holes in it to lighten it up a little bit. It's light, but it never hurts. I've also got to drill, sand some profile this down for my motor to stick up into. All right. I epoxied the boat on the top side one time with Vail. Once. Look at that. no dips and do's. I basically sanded all the veil off. I would say 80% of it. Alright. It gave it some strength. Look at that. It gave it some strength. Okay. And I didn't have to put two or three coats of, fillers, epoxy. I didn't have to go two or three coats with it. Now, the bottom, this is my second coat without veil. All right. I did the black first. Okay. And then I laid down this epoxy last night. All right. I think I'm going to have to go through and fill some areas on the bottom. We'll see. We'll see. But only laying down epoxy, it don't add any strength. See that right there? I'm pushing in on it. It don't add strength. That's why I put the veil up top. All right, I'm always dinging my boats, beating my boats up. I added cloth right here, the chopped up cloth that I showed you guys how to do in the last video as like a glue. I added a little bit of it right here last night and right here. That way, look at that, solid. That way we don't break it, all right? So I'm going to get to sanding. I got a lot of sanding to do on the bottom here. But my ride pads are done. They're pretty much done. I may put, after I paint the boat, I may tape it off and put a thin coat of graphite epoxy on here just to, so I can sand it back off and finalize it, but it's done. All I gotta do is sand all this down. So let's go to it. Yeah, you gotta be real careful not to sand through your epoxy. You gotta sand, look, sand, look, sand, look. Make sure everything's straight. I like to use sanding blocks. I just use hardwood. This is like a piece of, bloodwood that I've planed out with my planer. It's flat as a flat. I use that because you can scrape the sandpaper off. I use contact cement to put my sandpaper on, and you can scrape it off. This hard wood won't splinter. Unlike a piece of oak, the wood will splinter, like right here, when you scrape the sandpaper off. 150 grit. So 196, that's not bad. 196. So that's 150, 175. Dr. Jet suggested 150, 175, 175 being heavy. 30 grams over? 20 to 40 grams, depending on how you look at it. Light or heavy. With the cowling and wing on there, you're looking 240, all right? Without hardware, motor, ESC. Okay. It's a little heavier. I went through a few extra steps to ironclad it out. You know what I'm saying? A little heavy, but I wanted some weight. I said that in previous videos. I wanted it to be light, but I wanted it to be a little bit heavy so it don't blow off the water. Okay. And the graphite on the bottom is pretty much what did it. The graphite on the bottom of the boat is heavy. That's heavy. All right. Also, I put foam in my non-trips back here so I don't break my non-trips, okay, to back my non-trips. And I put the veil on top. Okay, so that's what added the weight. All right. I could deal with that. She's going to float now. Actually, you know what? She's going to freaking fly. Oh, my batteries are done. Let's go play. Oh, both of them. I love hearing that. I love hearing both of my batteries balanced out at the same time. Huh? So what I'm doing now, I'm going to actually cut my wing down. All right, cut it down to size so it's not sitting on the boat like this. Now, I don't know if the actual Atlas Vans has a wing like that or not. I need to look it up. But even if it does, I don't like it like that. I want mine straight up and down, okay? And I want it to be about, instead of being this tall, I want it to be this tall. I want it to be a little bit more low profile, all right? So what I'm going to do, I basically got it marked right here. I'm going to cut this side and this side. I can't remember if my pin goes in that far or not. So I'm just going to take my hobby knife and scribe down both sides, see if the pins are that far back. If not, I got some more carbon fiber. I don't need much to go into this little side right here. So that's my plan. I'm going to cut it down a little bit lower and make it shorter so it's not sitting like this. I don't like the way it looks. I'm not going to paint. I'm not making it a scale boat. I'm actually going to use, I'm going to make it the Atlas Vans. And it's going to say Atlas Van and all that stuff. But I'm actually going to use a different color scheme. I want it to be different. I don't like my boat looking like everybody else's. I don't want it to be just the run-of-the-mill Atlas Vans look-alike. You know what I'm saying? I want it to be ironcladded out. Something different. Something fresh. Okay? The Blue Buster. Okay?
Let's get this wing cut down to size. Huh? Gotta think outside the box, huh?
Here's a picture of the Atlas Vans 1:1, and it does have a little canter out on the wing. The way my wing was cut, the wing would have been way out here, and the angle would have been like that, all right? And I did not like that. I wish I would have checked it. I wouldn't have had to go through all that trouble to cut it. So I cut it lower, all right? I cut it lower. I cut it shorter. Okay, you see that? That's gonna look cool. And I was gonna make it removable, but I see why Dr. Jet had it designed where the wing was like this, so basically follow that non-trip and you get more surface area down there for these carbon fiber pins to hold in on. All right, so I'm gonna make mine permanent. Since it's gonna be low profile, I shouldn't have to worry about it breaking off when I crash or something. I'm gonna epoxy it with some veil on the corners here. I may sand this top part flat with the wing, that way I get a nice like corner with my veil, make it like streamline. And I'm just gonna cut my carbon fiber tubes, I mean my rods, like right here, okay, and I'm gonna epoxy it in. Boom. You know, I really don't think the wing would have done much for aerodynamics as it was, the way it was designed, like, you know, with a big canter out. Yeah, it would have caught wind, and it would have done either one of two things. It would have helped push the bow down, or it would have pushed the bow down too much. You know what I'm saying? So, I chose the lesser of two evils, you know. And building it the way I want to build it. All right, so that's going to look cool. It's going to look cool. So the motor that comes with this boat, it's an outrunner motor, right? An outrunner motor, and it's air-cooled, okay? Dr. Jet recommended not to run water cooling in the boat. It adds weight, and it shouldn't need it on 2S. But I'm going to be running this boat on 3S, okay? Also, going to be running other motors in this boat. All right, on 3S. And running this boat on 3S is probably going to get warm, you know, with a small prop, big prop. It's going to get warm. ESC is going to get warm. So it needs, I need to be able to run water cooling. Okay, I've got this little spot right here hollowed out on my hatch. It's for the motor to sit in. All right, that's basically comes, you know, in the kit. It's got a little hollow out for the motor. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to hollow it out a little bit more. I'm going to elongate this hollow area all the way back. It's going to save weight. All right. Plus, it's going to give us more room in the hatch for water cooling lines, battery connectors, battery wires to tuck up above this cowling. All right. If we needed to, we can, like, our battery connectors can go over this, and it'll have a little place to tuck up into. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to take this little round chisel, hobby chisel, all right? And we're going to do the same thing I did right here, but I'm going to bring it all the way back to here. Okay, all of that's going to be hollowed out. You got me? And then we'll epoxy it or whatnot. Got to do the same thing. I got to cut it out on this, cut the whole cutout out. All right, because it's going to be sitting on there like that right there, and it's all going to be supported. So basically, I'm going to make it hollow all the way to here, basically. All right, so I'm going to get started on it. Domed out this right here, turned out good. I'm glad I thought about this. I went through to that hole right here, and I just I cut a square balsa out, and I filled it in. All right, I cut through to the cockpit area, cut a piece of balsa, filled it in. That's going to give me way more room than I really need. Really. You'll never even know all that stuff's there once I put the epoxy and paint and stuff on it. So you know, it looks freaking good. It's looking good. So I took, my time. I thought about everything. And I'm ready to epoxy. I'm ready to epoxy. All right, you guys. I got some epoxy mixed up. I got some veil. This is really thin fiberglass sheet. It's surfacing veil. All right. It's very, very thin. Paper thin. Okay. I got a couple little squares cut out. I'm going to put it on my joint on this wing right here. Alright, probably on the underside, probably just do the underside, but that stuff adds some structure. I did it to this hatch right here, and the top side of my boat, but I did it to my hatch, and normally if you did that number right there with balsa, it would bend. Look at that, one coat of veil on one side, and the other side just has one coat of epoxy. Alright, look at that, it stiffens it up. And it don't take much epoxy to wet it out. So you could smear the epoxy thin like I did on the top side of this boat. It filled in any little dipty dudes I had in my boat, because you've seen me, I did the whole top side of this boat. I ain't got time to play around. This isn't like perfection game for me anyway. I know a lot of guys put a little bit of epoxy around the edges and they're waiting for it to smash out and they wipe it and all this shit. Not me. I put it on there and let's get it. Let's go. You know what I'm saying? I build my boats to run. I build them to run hard. I build them to crash and bash and just have fun with it. I'm not a freaking racer. I don't count every single little gram. I like my boats to be light. Don't get me wrong, but I don't count every freaking gram. I'm gonna get at it. All right. I build my boats to run. I build them to have fun. I don't race. I don't have nobody to freaking race with. If I did, I might go a little bit lighter. But I build my boats ironclad. I build them ironcladded out, you know? Hell, I want it to last me. I want to give this boat to my son one day, you know? So I build it ironclad. All right, let's get it. We'll be right back.
Oh yeah. It's epoxied. I didn't put no hairs on it to fill any gaps or anything in case I need to sand some more. Had a little guy to fix here, a little low spot I wanted to level out, so I put a little piece of veil there. Got the veil on the underside of both sides. Used the C-clamp here, adjustable clamp, to clamp it into place. So it's straight up and down on both sides. And I had a little place to fill right there. One little ding on the top side. But so yeah, we're gonna let it cure out. I'm not gonna make you guys watch all that. But yeah, like I was saying, I build my boats to freaking run. I build them to have fun with. It's not a freaking world record boat. It's not gonna be, you know, doing speed runs or no crazy shit like that. I build them to have fun with, and I build them tough. It may be a little heavy, you know, 50 grams heavier than I wanted it to be. But hell, I know that son of a bitch ain't gonna fall apart when I flip it. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, appreciate you guys watching. Thanks for tuning in with Big B with Ironclad RC. I'm gonna let you guys go. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to the channel. Ring my bell. Ring the bell. Ring the little bell. Get notified for future builds, future projects. We'll see you guys next time.